Thanks again for tuning in with us. We hope you have enjoyed the show so far. Remember to follow along at creeksidemerchant.com so you can shop the show. Now, the next vendor coming up is a true artisan, guys. Lynn Aultman with Aultman Sawmill really has a passion for what she does, and it really shows through with the high-quality pieces she is able to craft from wood. Let's head over to hear more about Aultman Sawmill.
Hi, I'm Lynn Aultman of Aultman Sawmill and Custom Wood Products, and I'm delighted to be here today as part of the Fishing Creek Craft Show Virtual Edition, not only to bring you some handcrafted wood products, but also to help the show fulfill its mission of giving back to the community. A portion of the proceeds that are raised from this show and through creeksidemerchants.com, which is the website that we're using for this show, will be donated to Second Harvest Food Bank of Metrolina. Your purchase will help to provide food and necessities, other necessities, to people of need in our community, in our area. So I'd just like to thank you for being with us and for helping to make a difference. Now I'd like to talk a little bit about the products that I make and the wood. All the products that I made are handcrafted from wood that is sawn by Buddy, my husband, and the sawyer for Aultman Sawmill. He saws these from logs into boards, and then I take the boards and make the wood products. Occasionally, if I'm working on a project that calls for a type of wood that we don't have, then I may have to purchase that somewhere else, but it really doesn't happen very often. By having our own sawmill and the capability to saw different woods and saw our own woods, we have the opportunity to utilize some woods that may not be available readily from other sources. And some examples of that are holly, persimmon, sycamore, sweet gum, and yes, I said sweet gum. Sweet gum has a reputation for being a trash tree, just because of those pesky little sticky balls that you step on and hurt your foot, and also because of the temperamental core of the wood. But some of those trees do have a gorgeous grain, and if sawn and dried properly, they can make really stunning pieces. I'd also like to talk a little bit about finishing. Whenever I make a product, of course, it has to be finished, and any of the products that come in direct contact with food, I use food-safe mineral oil on those pieces. It might be marketed as butcher block oil or cutting board oil, but it is food-safe mineral oil. Any other pieces like Lazy Susans or essential oil pieces, anything that doesn't come in direct contact with food, I use a two-step process. The first process is using shellac mixed with denatured alcohol. I use several coats of that. And then as a top coat, I use polyurethane. And again, it may be several coats of that. Now I'd like to show you a few pieces that I've made that are available through the website, creeksidemerchants.com. There will be a full description with dimensions, cost, tax, etc. So let's start with Lazy Susans. I have three of them here. The first one is made from cherry. It has a classical bit edge profile and 18 inches in diameter. All three of these that I have are 18 inch diameter Lazy Susans. The second one is made from cherry, hickory, and walnut. The edge profile on this one is a chamfer bit, which is a bevel bit. The third one is ambrosia maple. It has a cove bit as the edge profile. And ambrosia maple is one of those woods that we don't usually have in stock, so I did have to purchase the wood from another source. Each of these is put together using a berry, which allows them to turn. Some of the other pieces that I'll show in this segment are carving boards. This carving board is made from cherry. It has a juice groove, and it has a walnut inlay in this one. This one's a little bit larger board, which will accommodate your larger turkey for Thanksgiving or big piece of barbecue. Second one is just a little bit smaller. This one is also made from cherry, has a juice groove, and also has hardware handles. Makes it a little bit easier to pick up. Those are the products I'd like to show you in this first segment. In the second segment, I'll show you other products which are also available on the website. Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching at home. Please be sure to check us out online at creeksidemerchant.com and get all of your shopping needs from all of our fantastic vendors that you see here today. We want to ensure that we're supporting a great cause, but today, some of our causes are going to Second Harvest Food Bank in Metro Lyme.
That's right, Matt. Now we are going to say hey to our friends over at Lincoln Road Farms and see what kind of goodies they have for us today.
Hi, we are so excited about being part of this. We were so looking forward to the live event, and we're just thrilled that this event has not been canceled, that we found a way to come to you and bring our products to you and help everybody have a lot of fun. I'm Robin Front, and I'm the owner of Lincoln Road Farms, and I want to tell you a little bit about how we got here. I grew up on the farm that you see behind me. It's a small place now. At one time, it was a large farm and has come down, like a lot of other farms, to a small acreage. But here, I raise a few beef cattle from time to time during the year. And 3 years ago, I started a baking business out of my home. You may or may not know in South Carolina that there is a cottage food law, and it allows you to bake certain things in your home up to a certain amount of money. And when you reach that point, then you need to move to a commercial level. We're not at that level yet, but we'd like to be one day. So I bake under the cottage food law and abide by those rules. And I'm probably going to tell you a little bit more about those as we go along. But the way we got started is kind of interesting and kind of fun. I was at a family reunion, and my cousin's husband was eating one of my buttermilk biscuits. So I'll let you take a look at those. We have the buttermilk biscuits right here. And he said, "Can you make them in a cheese biscuit?" Well, I've never been anybody's great cook, as a matter of fact. I like to bake, but other than that, don't challenge me. And I said, "Well, I don't know. I've never tried." So I came home and for some reason started experimenting. And my sister got in on the act with me, and we took a recipe and adapted it enough that I believe it's my own now. We spoke with my cousin's husband's friend about mini cheese biscuits. He was interested in finding someone to make them for him and turn it into a business. But at that point in my life, I couldn't get in. There weren't finances. There were other things going on that prevented it. So I started making the mini cheese biscuits, and I think I started selling them to friends and family, maybe a little bit on Facebook. That went on for about 6 months. And then a friend of mine at my work, where I worked at that time, said to me, "You should sell at the Rock Hill Farmers Market." I'd never thought about doing anything like that in my entire life. So I said, "Okay, let me see what we can do." Signed up, went to the meeting, found out all the rules, made a little bit of money. Showed up on the first Saturday to be there, did not know what I was doing, did not bring enough money to make change, had to get my friend to bail me out, tell me what to do, but found out that I really enjoyed it. I enjoyed interacting with the people, making something that they liked, trying some of the things that they suggested, and since that time, have made a lot of friends that way and truly enjoyed it. Found out by selling at the market that we have some best sellers, and I'm going to tell you about a couple of those right now. Cheese rings are our number one product. Now, you either know about cheese rings in the South, or you call them cheese straws, or you don't know anything about them at all. You're from some part of the country that's never heard of such a thing. But cheese rings, in my opinion, are absolutely delicious. These are the things that we fight over at Christmas. My mother used to make them, and then my sister took up the mantle and started making them. And so for the business, my sister said, "Well, you know what? I could make the cheese." She used to make a few dollars here and there. So she starts production of the cheese rings and outstrips me as far as what sells, which is a really great thing. It is our number one product. It's a baked cheese snack. It's got a little kick of cayenne in it if you want it. We do custom orders. We can make it without, and we can make it a little hotter if you like it that way. But that's our number one product. That is followed by the pimento cheese biscuits. So if you remember me talking about that, how we got started, the pimento cheese biscuits are our second best seller. They have a tiny hint of cayenne in them. And it's not like a pimento cheese biscuit that you put pimento cheese on. It's in the dough. It has a nice cheesy flavor. It's just a nice little addition to a meal or to serve as a snack. I'm not really sure what our third bestseller is. We make a lot of different kinds of things at Lincoln Road Farms. And when I say we, I'm referring to my sister, but really the only thing she makes is cheese rolls. And I'm grateful that that's what she does because I can't make them. I make pound cake, got a little bit of old-fashioned five-flavor pound cake here. I also make a chocolate quick bread that is really cake and bread consistency at the same time. It's just a delicious chocolate cake. The buttermilk biscuits that we talked about a little bit ago. Martha Stewart's chocolate crackles. Now these are, as they say, to die for. These are difficult to make. I charge a little bit more for them because they take a lot longer to make, but they are double chocolate and they are double good. And so that is a popular item once people try that. And then finally, I'm going to tell you in a little while a little more about our mini cakes, because I offer different sizes of our cakes. You can buy a full cake, you can buy a loaf, you can buy a mini version if you want to. So we'll talk a little bit more about that later on. I'm going to tell you a little bit to finish up that our cheese rings at this point are made the old-fashioned way. If you're of a certain age, you will recognize this machine that pan cranked. It's a cookie press, and it comes with different fittings that will allow you to press the dough out in shape. For us, we use a little star shape, and right now my sister makes all of them by hand. But we're hoping that we can grow our business and move into being more of a commercial business, but still retain our home style of friendliness and our customers that have brought us to where we are today. So we are excited and we're looking forward to seeing the rest of the presentations for this event, and we appreciate your tuning in.
Thank you, Robin. I know that I cannot wait to try the pimento cheese biscuits. All right, guys, I also want you to know that in addition to tipping Matt Tucker through Venmo, PayPal, and Cash App, we also have a special section for him on our website where you can tip him as well.
I know you loved him a long time ago. And even now in my arms, you still want him, I know. Darling, this time your memories die. When you hold me tonight, don't close your eyes. Don't close your eyes, let it be me. Don't pretend it's him in some fantasy. Darling, just once let yesterday go. You'll find more love than you've ever known. Just hold me tight when you love me. Don't close your eyes. Maybe I've been a fool, holding on all this time. Lying here in your arms, knowing he's on your mind. But I keep hoping someday you'll see the light. tonight. Don't close your eyes. Don't close your eyes. Let it be me. Don't pretend it's him and some fantasy. Darling, just once, let yesterday go. You'll find more love than you've ever known. Just hold me tight when you love me tonight. Don't close your eyes. Don't close your eyes. Let it be me. Don't pretend it's him in some fantasy. Darling, just once, let yesterday go. You'll find more love than you've ever known. Just hold me tight when you love me tonight. Don't close your eyes. Just hold me tight when you love me tonight, and don't close your eyes.
Hey everyone, my name is Matt Starnes and welcome to Catawba Falls Events. I'm so excited to show you on property today. One of the things that we are running just for the Fish and Creek Craft Show Virtual Edition is a $900 discount on all of our deposits. That's right. Wedding, corporate, private event, church functions, whatever you'd like and however we can host you to entertain. Take heed of our entertainment today for only $100. That's a $900 discount on typically when we average around $1,000 for a deposit. For $100 today, you can hold your event, your date, and your time. Thank you.
I wake up on the right side of the bed. I stand up. Run my fingers through my hair, walk down the stairs and you ain't there. For the third week in a row, where did you go? I get home and you don't so much as say hello. I sit down and you walk out, don't turn around, I don't know how. Far away can be so close, where did you go? When you gonna come back to me? Tell me how to find you, baby. I ain't giving up this easy. Oh, so don't give up on me. Believe me when I say I'm hurting, I'm dying, I'm searching and fighting. I'm all alone. My best to give my love, but sometimes I still mess up. I can't do it on my own. Where did you go? Where you gonna come back to me? Tell me how to find you, baby. I ain't giving up this easy. Oh, so don't give up on me. Believe me when I say I'm hurting, I'm dying, searching and fighting, I'm all alone, so I gotta know, where did you go? Where did you go? Whoa, we've been here before, we've been through so much more, but still come back to me.